Hello guys, welcome to my channel. You finally made it.
Welcome to the channel.
Question today. Does anybody in the audience perhaps have a Yamaha receiver from 2020? So if you do, you might know that there's been some problems with HDMI 2.1 in last year's receivers. And this video is about that. For those of you who don't know, HDMI 2.1 is kind of the new standard now. The big difference is it allows 4K HDR at 120 frames per second. And I don't think that used to be an important thing, but now I would say it is, because the two biggest selling consoles in the world, you've got the Switch probably might be outselling the Xbox. Anyway, the PS5, the PlayStation 5, and the Xbox Series X. Those two consoles are probably the two biggest consoles, except for the Switch, not quite sure. And one of their big kind of selling points is high frame rate gaming with adaptive synchronization. And what you get in response for that, in return, sorry, is smoother video. And that's really, really important. If you're spending thousands of pounds on a new receiver, you will notice the difference. Don't think, oh, I won't notice the difference. 60 frames a second is enough. You will notice the difference. I can't tell you how much of a difference it actually does make. And really, I would prefer 240 frames per second, but I think we're away, you know, quite far away from that. That's more in the PC gaming, you know, side of the market. You know, it really does make a difference, especially when you're gaming. So anyway, the AV receivers of 2020, they were advertised as having HDMI 2.1. That's a good thing, but a lot of people were experiencing problems getting high frame rate content to work, especially from, I believe, consoles like the Xbox Series X and also Nvidia GPUs as well. Now, on Yamaha's website, there is now a statement that promises a fix for this problem, and here is what it says. So, it says here, update 4, HDMI 2.1, compatibility of select 2020 AV receivers with certain gaming video devices, May 2021 is when this was released. So the affected models are the RX V4A, the RX V6A, the RX A2A, the TSR400, and the TSR700. And it also says, for certain pass-through compatibility with Xbox Series X and Nvidia RTX 30 series of GPUs, congratulations if you actually have one of those GPUs. I've been on the waiting list for months. AV receivers 2020. It says here that these models will be supported via future updates. A future hardware update is required on the above AV receivers for customers who plan to connect the Xbox Series X or the Nvidia RTX 30 range of GPUs to use at 4K 120 Hz. The information below provides further detail for customers requiring transmission compatibility with the above AV receivers, blah, 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 blah. This is how they're going to do it. It says a free upgrade program or update program will be available starting in winter. I don't understand you Americans, honestly. Winter 2021 to update the HDMI board on these AV receivers to allow for the 4K 120 Hz signal transmission with these source devices. We will provide an update of next steps here this summer. Be sure to register your product. Remember guys, register your product to be notified of next steps and receive direct communication about the update program. Please note, you will not need this HDMI board update unless you are planning to connect Xbox Series X gaming or Nvidia RTX 30 video graphic cards. Don't listen to that, everyone. Get that update done, because you will need that at some point. These AV receivers currently support HDMI pass-through, 4K 60Hz, blah-de-blah. AV receivers, yeah, that's about it, really. Now, actually, one more thing. It says here the newly released receivers, the A4A, A6A, A8A, they are unaffected by the pass-through issue. They will only require future firmware updates to enable certain HDMI 2.1 compatibility. So these are the 2021 range of receivers, the A4A, A6A, and the A8A. Okay, so you got those, firmware update. Now, also another big manufacturer, or two firms, Denon and Marantz, which are part of the same group. They have also got around this HDMI 2.1 problem too, but they are using an external box, right? They're offering external block box that you plug in to your AVR. I'm not personally a fan of that approach. Already, we've got to remember, these units are big and bulky. They're deep. They don't fit on like hi-fi stands, like a lot of hi-fi stands, you know, and you're now having to add an external box just to get this to work. You know, when you bought those units, you might have been thinking about the space that you have on your shelf. You might have been thinking about how it looks as well. That's a big part of your setup, is the look too. And now you've been told that you need to smack something on top of that. I personally don't think it's the best solution. So I think Yamaha's solution is a lot more user-friendly. And I think also it's the right thing to do, because essentially you're sending this back to Yamaha. They'll open it up, they'll do a board swap of some sort, and they'll send you back a new unit. That's the right thing to do. I don't think Denon and Marantz are doing the right thing. I think they're 50% doing the right thing, but really it should be a board swap if that's what has to be done. And I know this is a logistical headache for Yamaha, but that's why I like Yamaha. I always recommend people Yamaha, because when they get something right, when they do something right, they usually get it very good. They get it right. But when something goes wrong, they put it right. They have the resources to fully support their customers and their product lines, even their old product lines. It's a really, really big company, very successful company. And this is one of the benefits of a multinational monopoly power. They're not always evil. They can be evil, but this is one of the benefits. When they're such a big company, they do have the resources to put things right. Yes, are you guys interested in the 2021 range of AV receivers from Yamaha and from Denon and Marantz? If you are, then I would encourage you to click the link. Is it here or here? I don't know yet. I'm not experienced at this, but click the link and see my comparison video to see what I think about these two receivers from 2021.
Now you subscribe or I smash you.